Say you've gone to your hairstylist, your barber, whoever, and at the end, you hate it. What are you gonna do? I'm gonna tell you how best to handle it. You tell them. Granted, be nice about it, be kind about it, be gracious, but you have to tell them. I know it can be scary, but the only way that we can improve as stylists is by knowing. If it helps, think of it as in you're helping us to hone our skills. Because we could be doing hair for 6 months, 30 years, mistakes happen. But we want to grow and we want to improve. So we do need the feedback. I always tell my clients, especially brand new ones, to give it a few days, and if they hate it, tell me and I will redo it for free. Don't be shy, just be honest with your stylist. We're here to serve you.
Trying to get the pink and purple out of my hair. I've used dish soap and what is the other stuff that Google told me to do? Took me a second, but it's dandruff shampoo, so I've been doing that for a whole week. It actually like took out a lot, but like obviously I still am like a cotton candy head, so I bought this stuff called Color Oops, and I'm gonna try that right now. So the goal is to not bleach my hair because I don't want to go bald yet. I'm gonna go bald, but not yet. So the first time in my entire life, I actually read the instructions and it said it won't work for pinks, blues, greens, lavenders, or purples, and I'm gonna do it anyway, fuck it. You know how it says on the instructions to do a little strand? Does like anyone do that? Because I don't. Okay, listen, that bottle did not come with enough at all. Oh my god, I'm already running out of time. It smells like blood, guys. Okay, this is serious. Okay, I just did this stuff, Color Oops, right? I had pink hair and it is turning it purple. This shit that's supposed to take out my hair is literally turning my hair purple. I have purple. Guys, my hair is turning fucking purple. I'm supposed to take the color out. This is supposed to take, it's Color Oops, guys. I don't know if you can see this in my camera, but it is I'm gonna go in the shower. I really want to laugh, but this isn't funny. My entire head is purple. I tried to take out pink. I hit purple. Okay, listen, I'm okay. I had pink and now I have purple. I'm gonna bleach my hair. And it smells like chicken. I don't know why. You're a bad thing. I know I fucked up. I'm just a loser. Shouldn't be with ya. Guess I'm a quitter. While you're out there drinking, I'm just thinking about where I should have been. I've been lonely.
This is me with a freshly shaved head, ready to bleach and dye it a light purple. So here we go with the bleach. This is the first time I've actually bleached my hair by myself, and it was kind of terrifying, so not gonna lie about that. This is me trying to get the back and realizing that my back profile is terrifying and wanting to cry, so yeah. This is it processing. It was really fast and scary. This is me looking like Slim Shady and kind of wanting to dye. But here we go, about to apply a hair dye. Wow, look at it go. It kind of splashed everywhere because the ends of my hair are so tiny. Back profile again, kill me. Process that bitch with some heat. There we go. Me the next morning, absolutely hating it and deciding I want to go darker. So processing again, and here we are. Wow.
How to bleach your hair at home. I haven't looked, but I'm willing to bet that there are several YouTube videos on this topic. Let me preface by saying I love getting your guys' hair questions. I love answering them to the best of my ability. But that's one of the questions I get that I'm like, oh, I can't. Understand that bleach is actually a really powerful chemical, and not only do you risk severely damaged, possibly even melted hair, but like chemical burns on your scalp, the back of your neck. Just think it would be really irresponsible of me as a professional to suggest that somebody do that to their hair at home. Please know that I'm not just trying to keep it like super secret. It's because I would feel really bad and really guilty if someone did damage their hair on my recommendation. If you love me, let me go.
Hey guys, tester and time. So here's a new client who had come in wanting to go super light on her first session. Unfortunately, she had way too much damage for us to do so. So we decided to do a reparative treatment and a test strand. From the results of the test strand, you can see that her hair was very fragile on the ends, that it was snapping off wherever it was damaged. Here were the results after just one deep reparative treatment called the infusion by Trust Professional in the salon. What do you guys think?
My hair has become dull and lifeless, so I'm going to do a hair mask. It's not dye, it's a mask. I don't know the exact difference. It's for hair that's already color treated, which mine is, it's just grown out. I'm a little worried that because my roots don't have dye on them that it won't cling to it or whatever, and I'm not sure about the science, but yeah. It says to shampoo and rinse hair before applying, but Brad Mondo always says not to wash your hair before you dye it. But I'm gonna follow the directions just in case this is like a totally different thing than dyeing, which I think it is. I also want to say I have an amazing hairstylist. Been going to him since I was 15. He is one of my favorite people on the entire planet. He's amazing. But I can't go see him right now, and my hair is making me sad, so I'll see you guys after my hair's clean. Looks a little more pigmented than I was expecting. I guess we'll see.
It looks like I've dyed my hair with tomato juice or ketchup. Put makeup on so I wouldn't cry. Why'd you guys let me do this?
Okay, so here's me fucking up my hair. First of all, it's no surprise this went to shit because I'm using box bleach dye. But of course I did it anyways, and my hair came out orange. And here I am, bitter as hell, telling y'all not to buy this bleach. Then I decided to do a second box bleach. And I don't know, I'm mad dramatic and surprised because I knew this was going to shit. Now here I am trying to tell myself that everything's okay, even though I don't have toner or purple shampoo and I'm gonna have to most likely bleach it one more time. You can dead ass see the crazy in my eyes. Now I'm eating candy because food makes everything better. Here's me dropping the candy. Here's me thinking about life.
My husband has been getting on to me so long because his hair is really annoying him because it's just grown rapidly. So my mum gave me clippers, so I decided to bleach it up like I normally do. I'm not a hairdresser. I'm so sorry. Let's see your hair.
Yeah, hilarious, because you ain't got to walk around like this, have you?
This is a video of my reaction of straightening wet hair. So clearly I've lost the plot because I am a hairdresser and this is definitely not something that I would recommend, but I just want to see what it sounds like and what happens.
And you're about to watch Not Your Average Bleach Fail. So, I've been doing the whole silver thing for about 4 years now. I know it doesn't look silver, but you might as well take my word for it. So, I haven't bleached my hair in 7 or 8 months. I usually touch up my roots every month, but that's not the case here. I'm not used to working with this much hair. It's been a while since I have. My technique is amazing. If you have not gathered that, you're thinking, God, how could it get worse from here? Well, you're about to see very soon. So, you're thinking, oh, this is bad. But this is even worse. Here's the burns on my neck. It started bubbling up. So, yeah, there's the bleach in my eye. I also no longer have fingerprints. Also, I couldn't leave it on my hair for more than 5 minutes once I finished. So you can imagine how my hair looks right now. It's bad. You'll see it get worse very soon.
Is it okay?
It is not. Why do I look like a freaking thumb?
Edward Scissorhands, I'm coming for your brand. Oh, fuck.
Oh, my.
It's not that bad. I don't know about the back, though. Oh, fuck me.
Oh, no!
Oh.
This is literally the stupidest idea I've ever had, but we're gonna do it because it's quarantine and we got nothing better to do. I'm gonna attempt to tone my hair with food coloring. Yes, I'm that bored. Here's my conditioner. Brad Mondo's coming for me. So I'm gonna add purple and then I'm gonna add a little bit of blue because like my hair's, yeah. So it is a very light purple and it also has specks in it, but I'm just gonna add some blue now. That's good enough. And now there's no going back. I'm literally just gonna mix this in with my hands, and this could be a very, very bad idea. Okay, now I'm doing this side. Oh my God. I just finished putting all of it in my hair. It already kind of seems to look like it's working, but I hope I didn't just dye my hair purple on accident. I'm gonna leave it in for a couple of hours, and I hate to do this, but like for part 2?
I'm done procrastinating. I'm gonna cut my hair. Okay, too much coffee. It's fine. I'm sweating. It's fine. I've worn this shirt for 5 days straight. It's fine.
Hope you guys liked this video and found it helpful. If you did, make sure you give it a thumbs up and subscribe to this channel. It does help support us, and let's know what videos you guys want to see.